And when Saul's son heard that Abner was dead in Hebron, his hands were feeble, and all the Israelites were troubled. And Saul's son had two men that were captains of bands. The name of one was Baanah, and the name of the other Rechab, the sons of Rimmon, a Behurite of the children of Benjamin, for Behurite also was reckoned to Benjamin. And the Behurites fled to Gittan, and were silent there unto this day. And Jonathan, Saul's son, had a son that was lame of his feet. He was 5 years old when the tidings came of Saul and Jonathan out of Jezreel. And his nurse took him up and fled. And it came to pass, as she made haste to flee, that he fell and became lame. And his name was Mephibosheth. And the sons of Rimmon the Behurite, Rechab and Benob, went and came at the heat of the day to the house of Ishabod, who lay on a bed at noon. And they came tighter into the midst of the house, as though they would have fetched wheat. And they smote him under the fifth rib, and Rechab and Benob, his brother, escaped. But when he came into the house, he lay on his bed in his bedchamber, and they smote him and slew him and beheaded him and took his head and got them away into the plain all night. And he brought the head of Ishbosheth and to David to Hebron, and said to the king, "Behold the head of Ishbosheth, the son of thy enemy, which sought thy life. And the Lord have avenged my lord, the king, this day of Saul and of the sea." And David answered Rechab and Benob his brother, the sons of Rimmon the Behurite, said unto them, "As the Lord liveth, who had redeemed my soul out of adversity, when one told me, saying, 'Behold, Saul is dead,' thinking to have brought good tidings, I took hold of him and slew him in Ziklag, who thought that I would have given him a reward for his tidings. How much more when